What's going on, guys? Hyper here, and in today's video, I will show you how to parse on Portal Keeper Hezabel. Now, if you check Warcraft logs from week to week, you might have noticed that a few people started using Breath of Sindragosa on this boss, and are actually doing quite well. You can still go with the conventional regular Frostsight build, but I decided to give Breath of Sindragosa a try. Since this was my first time using it, I do make a few mistakes, but I will make sure to point them out so you guys don't make the same ones. Now the first step on this boss is convincing your raid leader that you have to stay on the bottom platform, which is not a hard thing to do because Frost DKs are not particularly good at going up to the platforms since we have low mobility so we can't get there super quickly, and we don't have huge burst damage like other classes so we can't really do a ton of damage to those mini bosses. And our AoE is actually insane so we can help deal with those imps when there's fewer players on the platform. The build we'll be using is a regular Breath of Sindragosa build here with Ice Cap and Frostsight. It's the same build that I am using on Antoran High Command and along with the Bracers and Sephus. If you want to go with the conventional build, you just use the regular Obliteration Frostsight build with Sephus and Bracers that also works quite well. And if you check logs, in the top 100 both specs or both builds have a pretty decent representation. In this video, I will be using Breath of Sindragosa though, so just keep that in mind. Let's roll the clip and have a look at this boss. So as always, make sure you have Food Flask and Augment Rune, and then move over to the side of the platform where your tank will be pulling, just so you don't have to chase the boss on pull. And on pull, you just want to open with Remorseless Winter Obliterate, and you do not want to pop Pillar of Frost, because if your raid's DPS is about as high as our raid's, or even if it's a little bit lower, if you pop Pillar right now, you won't have it up for the imp, so you just want to sit on that and just build up some runic power, and then save up some runes for when the transport portal comes out. And then here, I just Remorseless Winter, pop my BOS with my Pillar of Frost, and I just go ham on these imps. Now, depending on how strong your AoE is, you might want to dragon this first pack. As you can see there, I had a perfect dragon with both Concordance and Fallen Crusader. But usually that pack gets destroyed. On this one, honestly, they spawn kind of separated, so they took a little longer to die. But typically those imps only live a few seconds, and we don't have enough time to stack up at least like 5 or 6 to get a big dragon. So I usually tend to just hold on to my dragon for the second set of imps, because I will be able to get a second dragon later in the fight. Now for this transport portal, again, our Pillar of Frost and our Remorseless Winter will be up, so you will see me sit on those and just save them for the fight. And as soon as the transport portal spawns here, I sit on my Rhyme proc, and then the imps start spawning. I use my Remorseless Winter, Pillar of Frost, and again just go ham on them. And you see me use Death Grip to proc my Sephus. Sephus will line up with every single transport portal, so it's a really good legendary for that reason, because you can proc it on cooldown basically. And then we just keep hitting the boss. Now there's not too much going on at this point. You can also use AMS to gain more runic power if you have BOS running and you know that the tank's stack is about to run out. It does magic damage, but I tend to just hold on to my AMS for situations where maybe we miss an imp cast, and I actually just try to help out the healers with it, which you'll actually see later on in the fight. Now again, we have Pillar of Frost. It's coming up a little bit later. It means I wasn't getting enough procs from my Ice Cap to reduce the cooldown on it. But hopefully, and this will kind of spiral out of control towards the end of the fight, and I will actually point out the biggest mistake I make later on. But for this transport portal, I'll actually have my Breath of Sindragosa, and so I just build up some runic power and wait for the transport portal to spawn. Now there, I shouldn't have Frostshrike'd because I knew that I have Breath of Sindragosa and the transport portal is coming out. So here I BOS at about 70 runic power instead of 90, and that's not exactly ideal, but it lasts throughout most of these imps, and then they end up dying like as my breath runs out anyway. So there you see me AMS, and actually my whole AMS gets consumed and I get away with 300k HP. So that was a pretty nice reflexive move that actually saved me there. From here on, you will see my Pillar of Frost get delayed further and further, and I actually end up popping it off rhythm, even though I should be saving it for the transport portals. For this one, I don't have Pillar of Frost at all. And then this is about the biggest mistake I make after this set of imps, where I actually pop my pillar when there's no AoE happening, even though I should be sitting on it for the next transport portal. So if you look at the timers right now, the next transport portal is in 10 seconds, and I pop my Pillar of Frost. Now this comes from playing Obliteration for a very long time, and with Obliteration, you pretty much just pop it on cooldown, and I didn't think about it. This is probably the biggest mistake I make in the fight. Right there, I should have held on to my Pillar of Frost until this next transport portal, because that would have given me much more overall damage. Now this portal actually spawns in the center of the room anyway, so it's kind of a crappy one. And we second pot here with Lust, because the portal group is up in the purple portal, and we just want to nuke these down as fast as possible. As far as ability usage goes, you want to hold on to your Remorseless Winter right before the portals come out, and then for AoE, obviously, you just want to Frost Sight and Rhyme proc. You don't really want to Frost Strike. Unless you're capped on runic power. And there are a few points in the fight where you'll see me just keep spamming Frost Sight even though I'm capped, because it's just overall more damage than if I were to use up that RP. But that's just kind of poor planning on my part, where I should have spent my runic power before the portal came out, because I knew I shouldn't be Frost Sight or Frost Striking there. Then we have our second dragon come up here pretty soon. And I have Breath of Syndragosa here. I should have popped it just a little bit earlier. And I actually just ended up dragoning those. So it overall wasn't that big of a damage difference if I would have Breath of Syndragosa there or not, because the dragon would have taken care of those adds anyway. And the boss just dies here. Overall, 2.4 million almost. Now, with bosses like Portal Keeper, the less AoE damage your raid does, the easier time you will have parsing on the fight. So in our group, as you can see, everyone is annihilating those adds and they're dying super quick. So I don't get that much time to just passively cleave to them and just stand around and spam Frost Sight. If you compare like my logs to someone else's, you will see that overall Frost Sight damage, they're going to get way more than I do, just because of how long those imps live. But if your raid is something like mine, where you have really high damage and the imps die quickly, then you're going to have a little bit of a harder time doing really well on this boss. But overall, if you kill the boss, that's all that matters, even though this is a parsing video. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope these tricks and tips helped you. And if it did, please let me know in the comment section if you have any questions. And if you enjoyed the video, hit the like button and sub to the channel. And you can also follow me on Twitter @LegendHyperion. Again, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you on the next one.